got a fair beastly engine crane. Between the two of us it was easy to lift the seat box out. Could do it on your own, but it's just an awkward size. Thankfully it didn't reveal any horrors. Land Rover did at least galvanise the seals, I think, so they seem to last quite well. There's a few more bits of the chassis I can paint, and unfortunately on this 109 we've had to take the exhaust out, which runs under the crossmember and over the mount onto that hanger there. Bit of a swine to get out. I'm not sure how I'm going to get it back in. I fitted it with the wing off when I did the cylinder head and the camshaft last time, but I'm sure I'll work it out somehow. Took the handbrake drum off of there yesterday. It's all cleaned up now. In hindsight, I might have left it. It would have been easier to sling the gearbox from the hoist, but I think I can put a rope through the top, so that shouldn't be too bad. I've just disconnected the clutch hydraulics, as you can see. Drained that down. I'll swap this onto the other bell housing when I build up the clutch mechanism. That'll be a damn sight easier. And then it's just a case of winding the union back in. It's always fun to line up. But yeah, no horrors revealed on the chassis. Just a bit of paint required. Bit of rust down there in that corner brace, but apart from that, it doesn't look too bad.
Staking some points off. I think that's definitely a good thing. Time they sell food too. Okay, 1 second, I'll just shift again. Yep.
Okay. Well, we can get Troy under it there, can't we?
Yeah, we can, yeah.
the gearbox is out. It wasn't too painful. It hasn't revealed any nasty rust. Borgenbeck clutch, could be the original. So just waiting on parts to rebuild the other one, and we'll be putting it back in again. So like all the best Land Rover jobs, we finished up in the pub for the carvery. But I thought I'd give you a quick look at this, just the state of it all. We're in that bearing. Absolutely knackered. Land Rover fault as well, the ceiling there's failed. Filled up the bell housing with oil. That's why it was always leaving puddles everywhere. So there you go, hopefully the parts will turn up. I hope the new one finished soon. Thanks for watching.